This is the Catholic Daily Mass Readings and Reflections for Sunday of the 11th week in Ordinary Season. Today's first reading is from Ezekiel chapter 17, verses 22 to 24. The second reading is from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 6 to 10. And the Gospel reading is from Mark chapter 4, verses 26 to 34. Thanks for joining today's Mass Readings and Reflections. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing to this channel. First reading, a reading from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 17, verses 22 to 24. Thus says the Lord God, I myself will take a spring from the lofty top of the cedar, and will set it out. I will break off from the topmost of its young twigs a tender one, and I myself will plant it upon a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain height of Israel will I plant it, that it may bring forth boughs and bear fruit, and become a noble cedar. And under it will dwell all kinds of beasts. In the shade of its branches birds of every sort will nest, and all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, and make high the low tree, dry up the green tree, and make the dry tree flourish. I, the Lord, have spoken, and I will do it. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. Your response, Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. It is good to give thanks to the Lord, to sing praise to your name most high, to proclaim your kindness at dawn and your faithfulness throughout the night. Your response, Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. The just one shall flourish like the palm tree, like a cedar of Lebanon shall he grow. They that are planted in the house of the Lord shall flourish in the courts of our God. Your response, Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. They shall bear fruit even in old age. Vigorous and sturdy shall they be, declaring how just is the Lord. My rock in whom there is no wrong. Your response, Lord, it is good to give thanks to you. Second reading, a reading from St. Paul's second letter to the Corinthians, chapter 5, verses 6 to 10. Brothers and sisters, we are always of good courage. We know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. We are of good courage, and we would rather be away from the body and at home with the Lord. So, whether we are at home or away, we make it our aim to please Him. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may receive good or evil according to what he has done in the body. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, Alleluia. The seed is the word of God. Christ is the sower, all who come to him will live forever. Alleluia, Alleluia. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark, chapter 4, verses 26 to 34. Jesus said this parable, "The kingdom of God is as if a man should scatter seed upon the ground, and should sleep and rise night and day, and the seed should sprout and grow. He knows not how. The earth produces of itself, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. But when the grain is ripe, at once he puts in the sickle, because the harvest has come." And he said, "With what can we compare the kingdom of God? Or what parable shall we use for it? It is like a grain of mustard seed, which, when sown upon the ground, is the smallest of all the seeds on earth. Yet, when it is sown, it grows up and becomes the greatest of all shrubs and puts forth large branches so that the birds of air can make nest in its shade. With many such parables, he spoke the word to them as they were able to hear it. He did not speak to them without a parable, but privately to his own disciples, he explained everything. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Greetings, brothers and sisters. The Gospel we read above, we hear Jesus' two parables, the parables about seeds. There are two popular phrases we often hear, the bigger, the better, and the more, the merrier. Many businesses strive to be the largest in their field. People want to live in the largest home, drive the largest car, and attend the largest church. The greater the size, the better. The more, the better. The parables we heard contrast with these phrases. They both compare God's reign to seeds. The seed in the first parable grows slowly day by day. The second is about mustard seeds, which are tiny but grow to be large enough to provide shelter and shade. Both of these parables are about big things coming out of small beginnings. A few grain bags can produce enough grain to fill a silo. Birds of prey can find shelter in a tiny mustard seed. These agricultural images are about God's reign, not just farming. They both warn us to be cautious. We should not equate size with importance. Bigger is not always better. More is not always better. We have all seen how a small parish church can lose something vital when it grows into a massive congregation. A large organization is not always more effective. Quality products are frequently found in smaller businesses. Similarly, a majority does not always determine what is right. Minorities have frequently been the great change agents and bearers of truth for the rest of society. Minorities have brought about renewal and revival. The abolition of slavery, the establishment of civil rights, the protection of human life, environment protection, and political reform were all accomplished in the world by a small, dynamic and committed minority. As a result, we should not conflate size with significance. The church with the greatest number of members is not always the most effective. In fact, a community's size can often make it complacent, fat and lethargic. The renewal and revival that our culture and world require will come from a small group of people who are filled with a fire, spiritual muscle and the truth. They represent the future. Numbers can be a curse as well as a blessing at times. It is the intensity with which people still live their faith, not just the number of individuals who claim the name Christian, that will make a difference. The faith that matters is not the one that grows outward, but rather the one that continues to grow within. When we look around this summer at the beautiful world around us, we should remember the magnificent truth that the growth we see began with the small seeds that grew slowly over time. The same is true in our spiritual and religious lives. Our spiritual vitality begins with a drop of water at baptism. It develops through the use of a wafer of bread in Holy Communion and a smudge of consecrated oil at confirmation. Graces planted through those sacraments can gradually grow into heroic and life-changing holiness that has a profound impact on others. The same can be said of church life. The kingdom seeds are constantly being sown. When a parent teaches a child to make the sign of the cross, when a religious education teacher struggles to pass on faith truths in a catechism class, when a Catholic visits the sick, helps the homeless and counsels the doubtful. When we celebrate Mass and pray for the living and the dead, we are sowing the seeds of the kingdom of God. It is impossible to predict which of them will grow and at what rate. Growth will occur at God's appointed time. We sow the seeds, and God will provide the growth, as St. Paul reminds the Corinthians. As St. Paul says, the reward we will receive from the Lord is not for our growth, but for the number of seeds we attempted to sow. We all want to see a bright future for our world and our church. We have no control over whether or not this occurs. We should concentrate on faithful seeding and generous planting, leaving the rest to God. The mission of our generation may or may not be to harvest. The mission of each generation, on the other hand, is to plant. What is your reflection on today's readings? Please leave a comment below. Don't forget to like the video. Thanks for watching. May God bless you all.